the fact that an athlete has two careers, I think that is something we all must understand. The playing career and post their playing career.
Liaising with government organizations for a non-profit entity is often tricky, and it does have its ups and downs. What has that sort of negotiation been as a foundation, working specifically with para-athletes and also with the larger goal of developing India's Olympic challenge, so to speak?
Indian sport, I think, has come a long way. The fact that the government is replicating models like us and actually providing that support today is great, because today, you know, if you're a really, you know, high potential athlete, you can get support and you can get the government support. So in some sense, the pathway has got created. When all stakeholders realize that we all are working around the athlete and for the athlete, and this needs to be athlete centric, I think automatically things will change.
But what do you think the priorities are right now if it isn't athlete centric in itself?
There is politics in all areas. There is there's favoritism sometimes. There is, you know, there's a lot of things which used to happen. And I can definitely say that things have changed now. With every new sports minister that has come, it's been interesting to obviously have, you know, Colonel Rathor first. As a sportsman, somebody who's won an Olympic medal. I think that itself changes a lot of perspective, because you've been there, you've done that despite the system probably at that point of time.
Right.
But you know what you need to provide. And today, our Honorable Minister, Mr. Kiran Rijiju, is so open to collaborations and partnerships, and the fact that we're all talking to each other on a regular basis, right, it's a big change.
On that note, you were a part of a 10-member panel that made recommendations to the National Sports Education Board, right? And as I understand, such a board was intended to be set up to offer flexibility to student athletes and within existing schools, so students didn't have to drop out, shift schools, etc., to continue their sports. As a member of the committee, what was your sort of takeaways from working within the committee, and how do you see this education, the sports education board, develop and sort of create a space for student athletes to thrive? Because as I understand, it would just increase the pool of athletes that we have to select from, and then thereafter you have your athlete development programs that kick on.
The fact that an athlete has two careers, I think that is something we all must understand. Their playing career and post their playing career, and their second career could start very soon. So how do you prepare an individual to face life and be ready for life in both phases? Even me, for example, I used to play sport. I mean, that's all we used to do in school and college. But then there came a time when you had to choose education over sport. But if there was a board like this, which you could choose and continue playing sport, and it's not about Olympics, right, or a world championship, but the fact that whatever I am today is because of sport, what Absolutely. Sport has taught me. Sport is not just being an athlete, but if there is an option where from when you're younger, you know that, you know what, I'll do my best. I'll try and do everything in sport. If I don't do well, I still have a backup option. There's obviously a lot of sacrifices you've made as a sports person. You don't definitely have a normal childhood or upbringing when you play sport, especially Absolutely. When you start playing sport. So how can the system come together and make that a smoother process for parents and for athletes? So I think that was really nice to be part of. And globally, whether you look at an NCAA or you look at any collegiate program, they all, you have to do your studies and you have to play. There's no one or the other, right? So why should we choose in India? So I think that is why the board was formed. Even when you look at the whole Olympic, Paralympic medal tally options, we getting double digit and triple digits is going to take time, because we're not even participating in a lot of the events. So it's about increasing qualification first and then looking at medals.